just trying to align it. Let's see if I can get this nice and straight. There you go. I don't know if you guys and girls would be able to see it. Mars there. Sorry about the shaking, guys and girls. As you can see, it's actually moving. Looks still tiny and small though. This is at I think it's like 125 or something. Lens. So let's see if I can go up a little bit without going out of focus, sort of thing. So we've got Mars at the moment, as you can see. Nice and clear though. And you can just make out the sort of round edge circle. And the round, well, the axis of sphere in the middle of it. Let's see if I can lift this up a little bit. Right, let's stop that from shaking a set. So it is the 10th already. Actually, see if I can actually, because I don't know if it's going to come out of focus or not. Sorry about this. No, it's still tight. Let's stop that a minute. So I'm using my telescope. I've connected this to my telescope. Just taken some videos of it, of Mars. Yeah, so I'm taking some videos of Mars tonight, and just going to move this slowly, slightly, without trying to... There we go, just moved it over a little bit, so it's in the middle. Alright. Oh wow, you can actually see it slowly moving. And you can see it like sort of burning as well. Which is pretty cool. Anyway, I've got this Seben telescope which I'm using right now. I've got my DSLR camera attached to it. Using the T2 adapter. And then it's got like a Barlow lens connected to it. Even though the actual planet looks really close and it looks kind of big to my eyes, on this screen here, it still seems to be sort of tiny. So it's really tiny, really tiny. But you can still make out that it's actually Mars and it's actually red and all of that. So it's quite cool. Look at that, beautiful. I think you can actually see sort of like heat or something coming off that. Not heat, but you can see it sort of moving and it seems to be sparkling, which is quite cool. It's actually wonderful seeing something like this up close. Well, this close on the camera. I don't know if you can get the lenses even closer. I suppose you can. Buy like a separate Barlow lens and all that, or a different one, but this would be awesome. Just get another one, because this one's, I think, is like 125. So let's just turn that around there a little bit. Look at that, that is just some beauty there of Mars, and you can make out it's actually orange today as well, which is awesome. I've got a bit of a frog in my throat today as well, so I think it's just coming up to 12 o'clock, or just gone 11. So I'm just moving this slightly, that's why, so it doesn't go out like sort of stays in the area and all of that. Actually, there's quite a few stars out tonight as well, guys and girls. But this is pointing in the south direction, which is awesome. It's actually sparkling mad tonight. Literally. Sparkling mad. Oh, yeah, that's awesome. I like the stars at night. But this is not a star, this is an actual planet we're actually seeing and witnessing and all that. That's awesome. Assuming I've got this close now, when the moon comes this month in August, at the end of August, I'll be definitely recording that up close and personal with my telescope. And I should be able to get some good sort of craters on there as well. I mean, I could use my 800mm, but this one's a 700+, so it should come out more clear than the telephoto ones. Because these are what the lenses were made for, the Barlow lenses, just so you can get up close and personal. Even though it looks like a blob on the screen here, but you can actually see it actually moving. Literally moving. That's just awesome. Actually, I don't know if I can focus it in anymore. I think this is the best I'm gonna get. Actually, see if I can. And I'll see if I can lift that down like that. I wanna try and see if I can focus in. So it's much clearer. No, I don't. No, I think this is the best I'm gonna actually get in to focus, but you can see it slightly moving. It just seems like pixel, one pixel on a screen of Mars. It's very hard as well to master the zoom, the DSLR and all that. Now, let's see if I can get that back into position. Seems to go out a little bit when it goes down because it's moving really fast when you're up close and all that. But that looks nice. Right, I'm going to finish this one off here. Sorry about the shaking, guys and girls. But I'm going to try and get some better ones of the moon when they start coming out. But yeah, anyway, cheers for watching, guys and girls.